This is a new day. I'm calling out the mighty hero. The forces that are for you are greater than any force that's trying to stop you.
And we believe today, God, that you will do what only you can do.
He calls you a barrier breaker, a prized possession.
Hello to everyone, and thank you for joining us for the Lakewood Wednesday night service. We're just always so glad to see you. And I believe with all my heart that God is going to speak to you, that you're going to be strengthened and encouraged, and that you're going to grow in the knowledge of God and in your faith. And if you'd like to, you can turn in your Bible with me to Isaiah 3, verse 10. And I want to speak to you on the subject, all is well. You may be going through a difficult time right now, but you are not alone. God is with you. He is on your side. And the Bible says, if God be for you, who can be against you? You know, Psalm 46 has really been strong in my spirit lately. Actually, God was speaking to Israel, but we've been grafted into Israel. And it says this, God is within you and you will not fail. I believe that with all my heart. So let's look at Isaiah 3:10. And I want to tell you that in this passage, God is speaking to the wicked and to the righteous, His people. He's speaking to the wicked and to you. And this is what He said. He said, say to the righteous that it will go well with them, for they will eat the fruit of their righteous actions. But woe to the wicked, disaster is coming upon them, and they will be paid back for what their hands have done. Let me tell you something. You cannot help but be blessed when you live for God. He protects those who serve Him. And today I declare over you, God's righteous people, what God Himself has said about you, it will go well with you. No matter what you're going through, all will go well. It will end well. You see, God is well able to turn it around for your good. And you know, sometimes it does seem like the wicked are flourishing, but it's not over, and you have to remember that. God is watching over you, and He said that it will go well with you. It will go well with your children. It will go well with your finances. It will go well with your health. See, I don't want you to forget this promise today. You may be in a place where you need to speak this over yourself throughout the whole day. I've been there at times. You just need to say, God, you said that all will go well with me, and I believe you. And see, when you believe and when you say that over yourself and over your situation, that is a peaceful and powerful place to be. See, God's peace will envelop you. It will guard your heart and mind. And this is exactly what the woman did in 2 Kings 4. It tells us that Elisha the prophet, he would pass through the town of Shunem during his travels. And in this city, there was a woman that we refer to as a Shunammite woman because the Bible doesn't give us her name. And every time Elisha would come through to visit her town to minister there, she would invite him into her home for a meal. Well, she eventually asked her husband to build an extra room in their home so that Elisha could stay with them. And she and her husband, they were wealthy people, but they had no children because her husband was older. And one day when Elisha was there visiting her, he said to this woman, this time next year, you will have a son. And her response was, oh, please don't lie to me, because she didn't want to get her hopes up. But as Elisha said, the next year, she gave birth to a son. Let me just stop and say this. There, I may be speaking to people, you have not been able to have a child. Even the doctors say you can't have a child. But can I tell you, every barren woman in the Bible that God touched had children. They conceived children. And I want to encourage you right now, don't give up hope in that area. I believe God is going to bless you with children. But let's start reading this story in 2 Kings verse 4:18, because this child got a little bit older, had grown up, and was still a child. And the Bible says in 2 Kings 4:18, when the child had grown, he went out one day to his father among the reapers. And he said to his father, "Oh, my head, my head." And the father said to his servant, "Carry him to his mother." And when he had lifted him and brought him to his mother, the child sat on her lap until noon, and then he died. And she went up and laid him on the bed of the man of God and shut the door behind him and went out. And then she called her husband and said, "Send me one of the servants and one of the donkeys that I may quickly go to the man of God and come back again." And he said to her, "Why will you go to him today? It's neither new moon or Sabbath." She said, "All is well." I'm going to go to verse 25. It says, "When the man of God saw her coming, he said to Gehazi, his servant, 'Look, there is the Shunammite. Run at once to meet her and say to her, is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with your child?' And her answer to all three of those questions was, 'All is well.' And when she came to the mountain to the man of God, she caught hold of his feet. And Gehazi, his servant, came to push her away. But the man of God said, 'Leave her alone, for she is in bitter distress, and the Lord has hidden it from me and has not told me.'" This woman was in bitter distress. Other versions say that she was desperate. She was deeply troubled. And you may feel that way right now. You're struggling. You're hurting. You're frustrated. You're desperate for God to move in your life, just like this woman. But notice in her distress, when all was not well, she said, "All is well." You see, she was not giving up on her son because her hope and her trust was in God. The Bible tells us that Elisha went to her home, prayed for her son, and God brought him back to life. It was a great miracle. And I just want to say, like this woman, your situation may look bleak, but you can put your hope in God. He is your refuge and strength in the time of trouble. That's what the writer did in Psalm 42. He was very distressed, and yet he said, "Why am I discouraged? Why am I so sad in my heart? I will choose to put my hope in God. I will praise Him again, my Savior and my God." You see, in the times of distress, Jesus is your place of refuge. He is your place of peace. He is your place of hope and healing. You know, even in her distress, this mother's words did not match her situation. That's faith. As she was preparing for the trip, she said to her husband, "All is well." When Elisha saw her coming, she said again to his servant, "All is well." She had this deep, confident trust that God was going to move on her behalf. Tonight, I want to give you three thoughts that will help you. And the first one is this: start replacing negative thoughts with the words, "All is well." Meditate on that truth from God's Word. Learn to say that throughout your day. Let that be your declaration of faith. It may not look well, you may not feel well, but we know with God's help, it will be well. You see, there are many voices that talk to you and me, especially in times of distress. And the first voice is the voice of the enemy that speaks lies. He is the father of all lies. And Satan tells you, just give up. He says, "It will never work out. You will never get better. You're hopeless." And then there are the voices of other people who will either speak negative words into your life or over you, or they will speak faith-filled words to encourage you. And so that's why we need to have the right friends, be surrounded by the right people. The third voice is this, the voice of God, which is His Word. And it is always speaking to you. It will always speak healing and hope. God speaks joy and peace over you. He says, "I am with you and I will lead you. Don't give up. Trust me to take care of you. Trust me to take care of this legal situation, of this financial situation, of your health." You see, God's voice is a voice of hope and healing. Just read the Bible for yourself and you will see. The fourth voice is your voice. What are you saying to yourself? What are you saying about your situation? See, our voice is the deciding voice. We can agree with Satan. We can agree with the negative words of others. We can agree with our own negative thoughts, or we can agree with God. And that's what the Shunammite woman did. In the midst of her distress, she said, "All is well. I'm going to trust God with this." Let me read 2 Corinthians 10, 4 through 5 to you, because it tells us how to handle negative thoughts and lies. And I'm going to read it to you. I think it's out of the Amplified Bible, and it says this: "For the weapons of our warfare, they are not physical weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow, and destruction of strongholds. Inasmuch as we refute arguments and theories and reasonings and every proud and lofty thing that sets itself up against the true knowledge of God. And listen to this, and we lead every thought and purpose away captive to the obedience of Christ Jesus, the Messiah, the Anointed One." There is so much in this scripture. First of all, we are to use God's weapons that He's given us, because this is a spiritual battle in the mind. The negative thoughts, they're proud, they're lofty lies from Satan, and they are totally opposed to God's thoughts. And the Bible says that we are to overthrow those thoughts, and we are to destroy every stronghold, every lie that exalts itself above what God says. We are to take every thought captive that does not agree with God, and then we are to replace them with God's Word. Let me ask you this. Have you believed a lie? Have you allowed a thought to become such a stronghold that you cannot move forward? Maybe it's, "I'll never get well." Maybe it's, "My child will never come back to God." Maybe it's, my finances will never work out. I'll always be poor. I'll always struggle in this area." Those are lies. And now is the time to rise up and say, "I refuse those thoughts. I refuse to believe what the enemy says, what others say, and I choose to believe God. And I break every stronghold in the name of Jesus." Amen and amen. See, this is what it means to take every thought captive. Get into the Word of God and wash those lies out of your mind. When the negative lies come about your future, remind yourself, "God has good plans for me, and my future is bright because I trust in Him. All is well." When you're concerned about one of your children, stop and say, "Father, I thank You that You're working in my child's life. They belong to You, and I trust that all will be well with them." You know, when you do that, it's like you dispel discouragement, you dispel hopelessness, and faith rises up in your heart. Remember, your voice is the deciding voice. So replace the negative thoughts with these words, "All is well." The second point I want to make to you is this. Sometimes when you face challenges, it's not because you're doing something wrong, but because you're doing something right. This is so important to understand, because many times we condemn ourselves when we start to have problems and we think, "Maybe I haven't pleased God. Maybe I haven't done that right. Maybe God is punishing me." But no, do you know that the Bible says that the Holy Spirit led Jesus into the wilderness, and that's where He met Satan. That's where Satan tempted Him. So you can be in the middle of the will of God and still have problems. 1 Peter 4:12 says, "Beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you, as though something strange happened to you." See, being in God's perfect will doesn't mean that you will not have difficulties. You will, in fact, I'm going to say something to you. You will not reach your destiny without opposition, unfair situations, and people doing you wrong. So you just have to keep moving forward. Keep doing God's will. When you're doing all the right things, you are making a difference. That's what I really want you to know. Your prayers are powerful and effective, and God is working on your behalf. The Word of God that you are declaring over your life is coming to pass. God is watching over His Word to perform it, and you are making progress. Let's read a parable that Jesus told in Matthew 13. It's verses 24 and 30. And He said this, "The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. And when the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. And the owner's servants came to him and said, 'Sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did all these weeds come from?' And his answer was, an enemy has done this. And the servants asked him, do you want us to go and pull them up? And he said, no, because while you're pulling the weeds, you may uproot the wheat with them. Let them both grow together until the harvest. And at that time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the weeds, tie them up in bundles to be burned, then gather the wheat and bring it into the barn. So sometimes we go through things and we think, where did all this come from? Why is all this happening to me? Like this story, where did all the weeds come from? I didn't sow these seeds. See, those are simply weeds that the enemy has sowed into your field to try to discourage you, to try to distract you. And the good news is, those weeds cannot stop God's plan for your life. Your harvest is still coming. So stay in peace and remind yourself, these are just weeds. All is well. Instead of falling apart and thinking, I can't believe this is happening, know that this is just another weed. No big deal. I didn't sow it, and I don't have to reap it. God said He would take care of it. So like this man, don't spend all your time trying to pull up the weeds. Let me tell you something, you cannot fix everything in your own strength. You can't fix people. And if you're constantly trying to straighten someone out or fix a bad situation, you're going to be frustrated. Let God fix it. Let God do His part. Hebrews 4:3 says, we who believe will enter into God's rest. See, at some point, you have to say, God, I trust you to take care of the weeds. And God is faithful to move the wrong people out of the way. He will restore what's been stolen in your life. Psalm 46:10 says this, be still and know that He is God. It actually takes a mature person to say, everything is not perfect. I wish things were different, but I trust God. All is well. I'm not going to be upset. God is going to take care of all the weeds in my life. See, when you keep doing the right things, even when the wrong things are happening to you, that's faith. That's persistence. That is what trusting God looks like. You are making progress. The third point I want to mention to you is this. Don't give the enemy any power in your life. I like how my brother Joel says it. He says, take away the enemy's power by not listening to him or giving him any place in your life. You know, the bee without the stinger is really just harmless. It's just like a fly almost. Well, Jesus removed Satan's stinger. He has no power over you, no authority over you. The Bible says that he walks around as a roaring lion, but it doesn't say he is a lion. His roar is bigger than his bite. And so sometimes you have to announce all is well, not just so you can hear it, not just so God can hear it, but so the enemy can hear it, so that Satan will know that you give him no place in your life. You know who you are in Christ Jesus. You see Satan for who he really is. Jesus defeated him. He stripped him of his power on the cross, and you refuse to give him any power or place in your life. James 4:7 says this, resist the devil and he will flee from you. It doesn't say that he might, but he will. You have to stand in your authority against his lies, against his schemes. See, Satan wants you to fall apart. He wants you to get depressed, and he wants you to give up on your dreams. But you can refuse to be moved by the schemes of the enemy because you know that God is in control of your life. People aren't in control of your life. Satan is not in control of your life. God is in control of your life. This is what Paul and Silas did in Acts 16. They were put in prison for preaching about Jesus. They'd been brutally beaten with rods and shackled in chains. But in that dark dungeon, at the midnight hour, they were singing praises to God and they were praying. What they were saying in essence was, all is well. Satan has no power over me. Those who put us in prison have no power over us. And they will not stop us from praising and worshiping God. See, when they did this, suddenly there was a great earthquake and the prison doors flew open. Their chains broke loose and they were set free. And like Paul and Silas, I want to ask you, can you praise Jesus in the prison? Can you worship Him in your midnight hour? When you do this, the chains will be broken. Circumstances will shift in your favor. God will show Himself strong on your behalf. See, when you pray and worship God, something happens in the spiritual realm. The forces of darkness are bound. Heaven begins to move. Angels begin to work on your behalf. Don't let Satan steal your peace or your faith, because with God, all will be well. Remember what God said in Isaiah 3:10? Tell the righteous, it will go well with you. You will reap a harvest of your prayers. You will reap a harvest of your righteous actions. And I just want to declare over you today that all is well with you. All will be well. All will go well with you in the name of Jesus. Don't allow the enemy to steal your peace. Don't allow frustration to come because of what others are doing. Know that you can trust God, that He's a faithful God, and He is working in your behalf. In Jesus' name, I declare that over you. I want to talk to you a minute about strongholds. You know, I just have in my spirit that some of you need to just stop and pray right now and say, God, what strongholds have I believed? What lies have I believed that I need to let go of? What has the enemy been telling you? What did your parents say to you that is against the Word of God? What have others said to you? What have you believed in your own mind? Today is the day to break that stronghold, to get rid of it. And so I'm going to pray for you. I want you to say, today as I pray for you, I let the stronghold go. Why don't you say it right now? God, I let go of these lies. I let go of this stronghold. I bind the power of the enemy right now in the name of Jesus. Now, Father, I just thank you for your people. Father, I thank you that they're precious to you, that you're watching over their lives and you're speaking to them. And Father, I thank you that this is the last day they are going to be bound by any strongholds in their life, by any lies in their life, in the name of Jesus. I thank you the truth has set them free. And Father, I pray that you would loose into them a spirit of faith, a new vision. They would learn who they are in Christ Jesus. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that they would stir themselves up to believe you, to believe your word, and to do your will. And I declare over them that there is hope for you. There is hope for your situation. God is moving in your life. He is directing your steps. Don't believe the lies. Believe what God says about you in the name of Jesus and know that all is well. All is well. All is well. Say it right now. All is well with me. Whatever you need to say, all is well with my children. All is well with my finances. All is well with my health. You see, God says, say to the righteous, all will be well with you. Before we leave, I want to give every person an opportunity to have a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. If you've never asked Jesus to come into your life as your Lord and Savior, you can do that today. And I'm going to invite you to pray this prayer with me. Just wherever you are, God, I admit that I'm a sinner. I'm in need of a Savior. I ask you to forgive me of all of my sins. Jesus, I invite you to be my Lord and Savior. I want to serve you for the rest of my life. Amen and amen. Listen, if you prayed that prayer, the Bible says that you just got born again on the inside. Jesus forgave all of your sins and cleansed you with His righteousness. You are now a child of God and He is your Heavenly Father. And let me tell you something, God will help you navigate your life better than you could ever do on your own. See, God has given you a new start in life. I like when I heard somebody say He's given you a new start with a new heart. And so God will help you in this Christian walk. And I invite you to just come to Lakewood on the weekends or anytime during the week when we're having different meetings and classes. There's an online New Beginnings class that you could be involved in. And it will just do anything you can to grow in the things of God, because we have all these resources and we want to help you. Let me close with a blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. God bless you. We love you.